Thank you very much, Gian Maria Busetto. Your study was very clear, very suggestive for the importance of MOSI. And then now we have a huge series of questions that they already arrived. I will start, then we have the beginning. Mario Iliceto was asking, dear Professor Alessandro Gerazzani, when you speak about carnitine, how many carnitine are you using? I guess free levocarnitine and acetylcarnitine, and then should be there. And then thank you in advance.
Okay, thank you. Yes, when we speak about carnitines, we have always to think about the combination of acetylcarnitine with L-carnitine. Both are able to enter inside the brain as well as to spread all over our biology. But the most relevant fact is that acetylcarnitine has a specific effects on the neuroendocrine pathways inside the neuroendocrine control of reproduction. We have already demonstrated in functional hypothalamic amenorrhea that 1 gram of acetylcarnitine was able to improve the production of gonadotropins inside the pituitary through the GnRH stimulation. Acetylcarnitine is cleaved. You leave the acyl radical, and carnitine is able to work on the Krebs cycle. And acyl radicals are able to modulate the opioidergic pathway, blocking the beta endorphin blockade on the function inside the hypothalamus. So it's a complicated story, the fact that the carnitines are able to modulate reproduction, but in this case, we need to have both the equilibrium. The Proxid women preparation have 500 milligrams of acetylcarnitine and 250 milligrams of L-carnitine moving and acting on such pathways.
Thank you. And then Mario Iliceto have also a question for you. Dear Gian Maria Busetto, can also an highly reduced dendrophosphate of oxidized semen sample be negative in relation to semen quality?
Exactly. This is a really the point that I wanted to stress. Why is important to measure the oxidative reduction potential? Because when you have a too high oxidation, you have a damage over the sperm. But even when you have a higher reduction, you have a damage to the sperm. Because a higher reduction can avoid a correct capacitation and acrosomal reaction. So what is important is to keep the correct balance between the oxidation and reduction. This is why you should measure with the myosis, the oxidative stress, in order to avoid to have too much reduction or too much oxidation. And for this reason, this can help you giving the correct amount of antioxidants. Because if you have a patient that is in favor of reduction and you give to him, for example, other antioxidants, it will make a damage because it will increase more and more the reduction and creating more and more damages. So it's important the correct balance. Exactly, this is the most important point.
Thank you very much. And then Nudrat Tazin can ask Alessandro Genazzani, can we use inositol for adolescent polycystic ovary?
Oh, absolutely, yes. Well, we have always to keep in mind that we are discussing about nutraceutical compounds, which are very natural compounds that are usually are present in our food, in vegetables, in beans, in seeds, or in the meat. So the correct addition of these compounds in our not so, how to say, well organized food of everyday life is able to improve the quality of the reproductive axis and of the metabolic pathways, not only in adult humans, but also in younger humans, especially in adolescents, where we know very well we might have not a proper, how to say, attention to the feeding and to the normal use of carbohydrates, pizza, pasta, potatoes. You know very well that kids are kids, so we have to keep everything under control. But in case of overweight adolescents or obese adolescents, probably we might start to keep them under diet and probably to add a little bit of integration with inositol. Yeah, inositol.
Thank you. Sorry. You're finished? Okay, then for Gian Maria Busetto, consider that nearly 30% of causes of male infertility are unknown. How much do you believe that the MOSI can explain us idiopathic infertility?
Exactly, this is the point. Because the MOSI has been introduced in our terminology and our building of the male fertility, exactly because we wanted to give an explanation of the 30 to 50% causes of unknown fertility. So we believe that between these idiopathic infertility, the oxidative stress can be a really important part of the of this. And for this reason, once again, measuring the oxidative stress, taking care with antioxidant can help keep the correct balance and maybe can decrease this amount of idiopathic infertility. And maybe can help even the couple that that cannot give an answer to their infertility problems.
Thank you very much. And then for Alessandro, could this mix of nutraceutical compounds be administered in combination with oral contraceptive?
Absolutely, yes. It's rather important to consider that whatever is the treatment that the lady would like to have, and I'm talking about a fertile women, we might try to focus on one side on the dysmetabolism if we have overweight or just hyperinsulinemia. But on the other side, we have to keep under control the production of androgens and also of estrogens in these women. So we can keep on one side under control the reproductive axis also with contraception, and there is no obstacle to have a just addition of nutraceutical compounds driving these metabolic features. Since I have showed you, we are working together with carnitines and mainly with arginine and cysteine on all the pathways and tracks working on oxidation, pro-inflammation, and insulin resistance.
Thank you. And then for Gian Maria Busetto, a question. What do you believe are the most important limits in your study that you have published on varicocele and the treatment with micronutrients?
Exactly. This is the limitation of our study is exactly what connected us to the new trial that we are conducting. Because what we found in our paper that, as I told you, it once again is the 17th most cited worldwide, we found that the most important limitation is that we didn't evaluate the DNA fragmentation and we didn't evaluate the oxidative stress. And exactly for this reason, we decided to conduct a new trial focusing only on varicocele patients, where farther than the spermogram, we decided to evaluate DNA fragmentation with the tunnel test and to evaluate the oxidative stress using the myoxidase machine.
Thank you. Thank you. And then for Alessandro, I combine two questions. One for Aquila Hassan, and asking how can carnitine, cysteine, arginine can be administered? And another one, for how long the integrative approach could be done? 3 months, 6 months, a longer time interval?
Yeah, that's a really intriguing question. The fact that we might have cysteine, carnitine, and arginine all together is just an oral addition. So we can just have these in a small sack every day. And we can keep such kind of integrative approach for very long periods of time. We have done a study for 6 months in a row, every day treatment, every day integration. But the experience that we made in these last 2 years clearly demonstrated that after a first relative long time, 2-4 months of integrative treatment every day, if we got the result of keeping the metabolic pathways under control and improving the reproductive axis function, we might reduce the integration just to 1 every 2 days. So we might have 3 times every week the sac of proxid women just to maintain the efficiency. And this is rather important, especially in those women that have familial diabetes, or maybe that they have a predisposition to abnormal function on the metabolic pathways. So we can reduce the amount of the integration, but we suggest to maintain it as long as we could, just to keep everything under control together with a good lifestyle.
Fantastic. And for Gian Maria Busetto, another question. What do you believe it should be the correct way to check and monitoring of the treatment with this integrator for the male infertility?
Exactly. This is a new concept because in the past, when you was having a male with an idiopathic infertility, he was giving to him compounds, antioxidants, and that's it, without any dosage, without any check of the effect of this. The only way that we were using to check the results was to making a spermogram before the treatment and after the treatment. Nowadays, we understood that it's not enough to make just a semen evaluation, but it's important, once again, to keep the correct balance between reduction and oxidation. And farther than the semen analysis, that is important, you have even to go ahead regularly with the meiosis evaluation. Because when you find that the reduction is too much, you have to discontinue the antioxidants. Maybe you can continue later, okay? So farther than the semen analysis, you have even to take in consideration the capability of oxidative stress measurement.
Thank you. And then a question for Alessandro. You have also shown a slide from Paolo Artini working in that. What about the use of this combination before and during IVF programs?
Well, this is another important aspect that whenever a woman is looking for pregnancy, and we might face several problems, tubal factors or maybe semen factors, that obliges these women to go through assisted reproductive technologies. Well, the problem is that probably if these patients are PCOS or just obese or just with a dysmetabolic situation, we might and we should try to improve these aspects before, a couple of months or 3 months before, they go under the assisted reproductive technology, since we should have all the setting of the reproductive axis and the metabolic tissues, as well as the ovarian function, under the best control of the insulinemic system, mainly also of the post-receptor signaling, such as of inositol. So the presence of neoinositol together with carnitines and together with arginine and cysteine is for sure the best improvements of the function of the reproductive axis, also under the stimulation for the ovary.
Thank you. And then an anonymous participant asked Gian Maria, please show that, if you can repeat the hormones to be done in the evaluation of male infertility.
So the hormonal panel that is important to evaluate when you have a male infertility is the testosterone, is the FSH, is the LH, and the inhibin B. But if you want to make a better evaluation of the testosterone, you should even include the SHBG and even the albumin. Because if you want to calculate the Wert-Mueller formula to exactly understand the bioavailability of the testosterone, you should include the SHBG together with the albumin and not only the total testosterone.
Thank you. And then for Alessandro, is this integrative approach useful only in cases of insulin resistance and or overweight and obesity?
Well, whenever we have overweight or obesity, for sure we have a little bit hidden, but we have insulin resistance and at least a slight reduction of insulin sensitivity. So the good health is the balancing of insulin resistance, which is occurring in specific physiological conditions, with obviously the conditions induced by overweight that counteract, together with obesity, the insulin sensitivity with the improvement of insulin resistance. On my opinion, in our experience, is obviously important to keep everything under control. We should do this with a lifestyle of every day. So we should avoid too much carbohydrates, glucose, and keep everything under control in terms of have the right nutrients, that is meat, which contains myo-inositol, vitamin C, also a little bit of arginine, and vitamin D. But this is not easy. So probably we might use these as a normal addition, maybe 2-3 times every week, one day, 2 days in a week at least, just to let the biology have the addition of those things that are not probably in the right amount kept with the food.
Then, Gianmaria, please, I wanted to have your advice, because you have mentioned that fantastic study done in Israel showing the reduction of 1.4% per year of the male fertility. And you are also speaking about lifestyle. Please, as you know, this starts certainly not only in adult time, this starts also in childhood and in adolescence. Then I would like, as you, as an expert on this topic, as wonderful urologist, please give to the mother and father who are following us your suggestion how to face this possible problem since the beginning.
Yeah, this is a really complicated question, because
yes, but
if I knew the answer, maybe I was winning the Nobel Prize. But anyhow, I have to be honest. What I understood in my experience is that it is true that your health is directly connected with your fertility status. So conducting a healthy life, not being obese, not having diabetes, controlling the hypertension can really help you in having a better fertility. Even the diet is really important. The correct diet helps you having a better fertility. Finally, unfortunately, the pollution and our lifestyle is not good. But how can I say about this? Is difficult to deal.
Yes, but also I think the way of dressing, because you know, in nature, God have decided that the testicle have to remain outside, while the ovary, they are inside to the abdomen. Yeah. And the testes are outside because they have to be at lower than 34 degrees. Then do you believe that also we have to speak with the mother and also with the adolescents to try to dress, leaving the testicle in the proper location?
Yeah. Even the education is really important. Unfortunately, we live in a life, we are in a life where education is finishing, but at all regards, not only for the how we dress, even in other points. So, and I believe that COVID gave us not any help in this. So really, the lifestyle, I think, is one of the most important things that we have to take care of.
Then we have a question for Alessandro. I think it's an anonymous who know very well you. Alessandro, what difference is there between the myo-inositol and the hero-inositol use in PCOS?
This is an incredible question that probably needs a couple of hours of discussion.
No, you don't have the time. You don't have the time. I give you 3 minutes.
We can shrink this to the important and relevant issues. Well, the presence of familial diabetes predisposes a reduced production inside the cells of the chiro. But this is not the only important element to drive the metabolic control inside the cell. We need to have also other issues, such as the effects of arginine, cysteine, carnitine, and also lipoic acid. So we might have a reduced production of the chiro, but if all the other issues or the other elements are able to modulate and to have an action on the control of the metabolic pathways, you might get the good results of having almost everything under control. The problem of the myo-dichiro ratio, which is an important issue that we should state, is under debate, and we are really studying these issues. It is quite clear that the perfection cannot be reached in any case, and nature does everything in her own proper way. So the equilibrium of all the elements are not the same in the same patients. It changes through the age. If it is of a certain level during adolescence, during fertile life, and during menopause. So we are just now trying to test and to set everything according to the moment of the life where we might have in the problem of the metabolism, the greater issues for health and for reproduction.
Then I will give an answer to an anonymous who is asking if male infertility has this, can we depend, is Georgios Sarzetis, can we depend on multi-ingredients formula with no documentation or multi-ingredient formulas presenting only the documentation of their ingredients? I think that we have to ask always the documentation of the ingredients, the quality of the ingredients have to be ensured. It's not only multi-ingredients in general who can be provided without any definition of what it is, how it's prepared, and what are the dosage. And then now I would like a final comment. We will start from Gian Maria. A final comment on importance of micronutrients, the importance of the new concept of the oxidation impact in male infertility, and your suggestion. And later on, to the same question to Alessandro, not speaking about MOSI, but speaking about impact of insulin resistance and obesity in this world. Please, Gian Maria, your final comment for this fantastic webinar. We have still more than 160 participants.
So we had a peak of more than 200.
Yes, yes, but they are still now at the discussion. It's fantastic.
Yeah, yeah.
Go so, on, go on.
So my final comment is by the end related to the previous question. So since I believe that the lifestyle is the most important part to keep our fertility in a correct way, and since it is difficult nowadays to keep a correct lifestyle because you are running everywhere, you don't have time to a correct diet, and for this reason micronutrients can help you to keep a better balance, a better situation in your metabolism. So by the end I really believe that day by day their importance is really high.
Thank you, Alessandro.
Well, the problem and the issues of micronutrients is essential, since whatever we are able to eat, it should give us nutrients or micronutrients. I again say that we are not having food in the proper way. It's not really taken from Mother Earth and from nature in the proper way, is packed and conserved in terrible ways sometimes. So the fact that we might add what is not really properly contained in the food that we are keeping probably gives us a little bit more capability to defend ourselves from the excessive oxidation that our everyday life is still promoting and producing inside us. So physical activity is perfect container of stress in a limited amount is perfect, but we are not able to avoid everything. So the presence of micronutrients and the addition of integrations in a specific right amount is able to face and to help our biology to be able to survive to all what is happening around us, including a COVID-19 story.
I totally agree with both of you. I am also using micronutrients, not for my fertility, I'm approaching my 80s, but to try to maintain the full body and mind in the adequate function. Then I would like to thank all of you. I would like to thank Alpha Sigma for that beautiful webinar who give to the ISGE, the International Society of Gynecological Endocrinology, the capacity to approach the micronutrients important in human fertility, not only taking care of the woman, but also taking care of the men, because fertility depends from both. And then I would like to thank all of you, and I would like to invite all the participants to the upcoming webinar. I just to remind you the dates and the topics of the upcoming webinar. Next slide. The 1st of December, we will have obesity during the menopause, incidence and implication, with two fantastic speakers, Professor Antonio Cano and Dr. Augusta Maturana, and Fred Naftolin will be the chairperson of this session. And the 13th of January, we will have hormone-dependent and independent aging of the pelvic floor, external genitalia and skin. And the master will be Professor Tommaso Simoncini, from Pisa and Professor Mark Brinkat from Malta, and I will have the honor to chair the session. Then, dear friends, dear colleagues, welcome again to our webinar, which are done waiting the time of our 20th World Congress of Gynecological Endocrinology in the magnificent scenario in presence in Florence from the 11th to 14th of May 2022. I wish to all of you health, prosperity, and be free from the COVID. Do vaccination, suggest vaccination, take care, wash your hands, use your mask, and enjoy the life, because we can also enjoy the life even with the mask, even washing the hands, and even making vaccination. Better living than to be out of vaccine. Thank to all of you for being with us. Thank Gian Maria, it was a fantastic talk from Foggia.
Thank you.
Thank Alessandro, fantastic presentation from Modena, and thank to all of you to being with us.
Bye-bye.
ISG, welcome. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, arrivederci.
Ciao, ciao, ciao.